As developers, we're spending a ton of time within browser developer tools, and getting just a little bit more productive within those tools can make a huge difference. In this video, I will outline some random Chrome DevTools tips that you will most certainly find very handy. Let's dive in. First thing, obviously, you will want to open developer tools, and to do that, use keyboard shortcut. You can use Command-Shift-I or Command-Shift-C, and on the Windows, you would replace Command with Control, probably. So I'm going to use Command-Shift-C because Command-Shift-C immediately allows me to select and inspect an element. I'll do this right now. Let's select this item right here. And the first tip that I want to share with you is using right-click in developer tools. It might sound silly, but it's really powerful and it's often overlooked. I myself wasn't aware of a lot of those things for quite a long time, so that's exactly what I want to share in with you. When you work in developer tools, you will often do a lot of changes in the Stats pane. Let's do a couple of those right here. And then once you make those changes, you'll probably want to copy, well, changed values. And what I used to do until just recently, I would select the entire declaration with my mouse, and then I would hit Command C, and that way I would copy that. And oftentimes when doing that, I would misselect the property name and I would end up with order instead of border. And then if I wanted to paste this in my editor, I'll just paste it in notes here. You would see that instead of border, I would get order, and then I would need to tweak that. So it's really not an efficient way to be working that way. But there is a much simpler way to actually do all of this. And this is just using the right click. So if you do right click somewhere on the property, you're going to see that you have a lot of very useful controls right in here. You can copy declaration, property value, rule, or you can even copy declaration as JavaScript. So let's copy declaration. I'll just paste it right here. As you see, I get an entire declaration without any issues. If I just want to copy the value, I can do that. It's really handy. It's really simple. And I wasn't aware of this for a very, very long time. Another useful thing is if you tweak more values, you can copy all declarations and you just paste this into your editor then, or you can even copy all CSS changes. And the problem with this is that it doesn't really work for me. I don't know why, but this particular option, copy all CSS changes, I cannot get it to work. If you know something about this, if you know how to set this up so it actually works, please let me know. But luckily, there is another way to actually see and copy all CSS changes you've made to this particular page in developer tools. And to do that, you can open command palette in Chrome DevTools using the command shift P. And this is an incredibly handy tool to use within developer tools. Get into the habit of using it, because if you ever want to find something, if you want to jump to a different pane or anything like that, you can very easily do this using command palette. Here, I'll search for changes. And the first option, as you see, is show changes drawer. I'll hit enter. And I have this panel here, changes, where I see all changes I made to this particular file. Or if you have more files in your page, you will see more files listed here. And then you can see all the changes you made, including the removals, additions, and so on. And then you can very easily copy those changes if you just hit the copy button right here. Let's see how this looks. So as you see, this would copy the entire selector, including the commented out old values. It can be really useful. And if you want to undo the changes you made without refreshing the page, you can just hit the undo changes right here, revert all style changes. Then all changes in that particular file that was selected will be reverted. All right, I'll close the changes drawer using the escape key. Right click can be very useful in elements pane as well. There's quite a lot of options. I'll show them right now. Some of those might be obvious, like adding an attribute or editing an attribute. And basically all of those commands you can do with double clicking, deleting an element you can do with the delete key, of course, and copying and pasting is something that you would do with your keyboard. Then you can hide an element, force a state like hover, focus, and so on, which is quite a bit handy. And you're going to see here a notifier that the certain state is forced. Let's remove this. And another useful thing here is expanding and collapsing children recursively, which means that once you hit expand recursively, all the nodes that you have within this particular element, UL in my example, will be expanded. So you don't have to click every one manually. You can just hit right click, expand recursively, or collapse children, which will collapse all children, no matter how many levels they're nested. But you can also do all of this using the keyboard shortcuts. So if I just hit left and right, I'm going to be expanding and collapsing one level. But if I'm holding down option key, I will be expanding and collapsing recursively. Another very useful thing that I'm using quite often, and this is particularly noticeable if you have larger pages and you're working with big DOM structures, and then you find a certain element in your elements pane, but you don't see it in your actual view on your page, and then you can use scroll into view option to focus your screen on that particular element. So let me just zoom in this a little bit so some of the elements disappear from the screen. And now if I wanted to see this element, it's not visible on the page currently, but if I hit right click, scroll into view, I will immediately have it in my view. Another option that is available here is hide element. And if you toggle this, this will essentially add a class to the element with visibility hidden set to important. There is a keyboard shortcut for that, and that is just hitting the H key. So if you have the node selected and you hit the H key, this will toggle this particular class, and you can very easily show and hide element if you ever want to do that for one reason or another. Next tip that I want to share with you is hovering elements in web developer tools. You probably notice when you're hovering nodes right here in the elements pane, those nodes will be selected on the page. This also works in styles pane. So if I hover my LI selector here for more than a moment, all elements on the page that are matching the selector will be highlighted, as you can see right here. And just as well, if I hover any of the properties, let's say we have padding here set to 10 pixels. If I hover this property, and if this property can be visually identified on the page, then this will also be shown. When I'm hovering margin, margin properties are shown. When I'm hovering padding, padding property is shown. And rest of the properties here can really be seen on the page, so they're not really highlighted. But any property that can be highlighted on the page will be highlighted if you hover it in the styles pane. Another thing about hover that I want to show you is when you're using this select an element option, Command Shift C, when you're hovering elements, you see this very useful tooltip with information about the selector, about the color, font, and so on. And sometimes this can get in the way for one reason or another, but you can very easily hide it if you're holding down Control key on your keyboard while hovering. I'm gonna hold down Control key now, and when I start hovering, this tooltip will not be shown. So if for whatever reason this gets in the way, just hold down the Control key, or it even works with the Command key, and this tooltip will not be shown. And another thing that can be useful sometimes is when you're hovering an element and this tooltip appears, you can actually keep it in place exactly where it is right now if you're holding down Command and Option buttons. So as you see, I'm moving my mouse now, but tooltip stays in the place. Element that was hovered before is still selected. So if for whatever reason you want to move your mouse away from the element that you have highlighted while this pop-up is showing, just hold down the Control and Option key, or Control and Alt on the Windows, and this pop-up will stay in the place exactly where it is when you started hovering that element. And just a note, this will not work if you hover outside of the browser window, or if you hover to developer tools, for example. You need to be within the browser window for this tooltip to stay in the place. Sometimes you might disable mouse events on a particular element on the page using the pointer events. So let's set this to our LI selector, pointer events none. So I will no longer now be able to hover over my LI elements, and I still have this select elements option enabled. So if I try to go around here, you're going to see that only thing that I'm selecting here is UL element. So if you wanted to select element on the page that has pointer events set to none, you can very easily do this if you just hold down the Shift key. So if I'm holding down Shift key, you're going to see that LI elements can now actually be hovered. So while I'm holding down the Shift key, I am able to hover over those elements that have pointer events set to none. Next thing that I want to show you is how to work with colors in developer tools. In this element, we have a number of colors. You can see them right here on my background. And if I click on this icon that represents the color, this pop-up will appear. And this gives you ability to copy the color, to tweak the colors, to change the format of the colors right here, or to actually pick additional color from the page using the color picker. And the thing about this color picker is it works only within the browser window by default, but there is an experimental option in Chrome DevTools that you can enable if you want to be able to pick colors outside of the Chrome, for example, from Photoshop or from Figma or whatever tool you're using where you have the design available with the colors that you want to use. And this might be very practical. If you want to enable that, you can open Command Palette, go to Experiments, Show Experiments, and then you're gonna have to enable color picking outside the browser window. So enable this option if you want to be able to use color picker tool to pick colors outside of the browser window. And I actually have another video on Chrome DevTools experiments where I go over many of those that you see enabled right here. So check this video. Link is going to be on the screen and in the description. Let's jump back to our color pop-up. As I've shown you a moment earlier, you can change the color format if you click on this icon here, and then you can select any color format that you want, which will transform the current color format into this new one that you pick. But there's actually an easier way to do this. If you're holding down the shift key, when you click the color, you will immediately be presented with a pop-up that allows you to change the color format. So if you just want to change the color format, you don't need to open this entire color pop-up. You can immediately open the option to change color format if you're holding down the shift key while you're clicking that. Let's jump back to our pop-up. Here at the bottom, you see a number of colors. And if you click this icon here, you're going to see predefined color palettes. This is a material one, custom ones, CSS variables, and page colors. Page colors actually offers you colors that are present on the page. So whatever browser finds on the page, you will see in this color palette here. These are the colors that are on my page right here. And another thing that you might consider using is the custom palette. And here you can add any color you want. Once it's selected here in the picker, you can add it to this color palette. And then you're going to have this available if you want to reuse it later on. And the last one, and this is also very handy, I think, is CSS variables palette. And this will show you colors that are defined in CSS variables. As I don't have any colors defined in custom properties, I'll do this right now. I'll add root selector. And once you type down the selector that you want, if you hit enter, this selector will be created, but you're going to have to click within it to be able to add property to it. But of course, there is a better way. Once you create the selector that you want, you can hit tab key and you'll be immediately redirected to creating a property. So let's create a custom property here. I'll just use red and I will set it to, well, let's set it to red. I will use blue and I will set it to blue violet. And let's set another one pink and we'll set it to hot pink. And now if I open my color palette, those variables should appear right here, but they do not for some reason. So let me try reloading developer tools and let's open this again. And now they will appear. And this doesn't always work consistently. Sometimes those variables will appear immediately, but a lot of times you will have to reload developer tools if you want CSS variables that you add within the developer tools to actually appear right here in this color palette. Another thing that you probably know about is, as I have this color icon here, I can click it. Exactly the same thing goes for all other icons that will appear within developer tools, like this angle right here. If you click on it, a handy tool will appear that will allow you to visually adjust that particular value. Like for Flexbox here, you can immediately set wrapping, aligning, so on and so on. Whenever you see icon in developer tools, you can click it and you'll be able to adjust settings related to that property very easily visually. And the last thing that I want to show you here is an experimental feature available within developer tools that will give you a nice overview of your CSS. I'll open the command palette again and I will search for CSS overview. And as you probably noticed in this video, I'm using command palette a lot and I think you should be using it too. There's actually a way to access all of those options while clicking and searching around the interface, but it's much, much quicker and much handier to actually use command palette and immediately find and jump to whatever option that you want to be using, to whatever panel that you want to focus on. So I'll hit enter here, show CSS overview panel. And as you can see here, this is an experimental preview feature. So I'll hit capture overview here, which will give me information about the current style sheets on this particular page that is open. I'll expand developer tools so we can see it a little bit better. And here you have a general overview. There are this many elements, this many rules, number of style sheets, media queries. So if you ever come to a new project or if you're working on your own project and you just want to see what the deal with CSS is, you can just open this CSS overview and this might help you identify some problems in CSS that might need addressing, like you might have too many ID selectors, too many complex selectors, and so on and so on. This can also give you an insight into the design of your page. For example, if you hit colors here, you're going to see which colors are used on the page. You're going to see any potential contrast problems that you have on a page. So this contrast is clearly not big enough and this should be addressed. Then we have font info, and this will show you all fonts that are used on the page. And of course, if you notice that there's too many fonts, too many font sizes, then you can adjust this, tweak this, and thus streamline your design. Then you can see unused declarations. And if there's too many rules in your CSS that are unused, it might be a good idea to evaluate this and maybe even remove some of the rules that are not necessary, that are not used on your pages. And lastly, you can see info about media queries. And on this particular page, as you see, there's only one media query, print media query. But if you have more media queries, you can find them all here. Hopefully you'll find at least some of those tips handy, and hopefully they will make you just a little bit more productive within developer tools. And if you want to learn more about developer tools, or specifically which experiments in developer tools you should enable, then watch the video on screen right now and enable all the experiments that I mentioned. They are really handy, really practical, and you should be using them. Until then, my name is Ron Yambor. Thank you so much for your attention. I will see and hear you in the next Chrome DevTools feature, or rather, in the next video.